Hey guys, welcome to another video. This time we're going to clear Necro B12 with a team that doesn't include Icarus. So yeah, what we're going to do here is use our old teams, which means we're going to use 4 twins and we're going to use Raok. However, this team, even though I'm using a ton of shield sets and some violent runes as well, this team can fail. This team, I think, is about 97% reliable. So yeah, it failed a couple of times. I actually tried about 200 rounds with this team, maybe a little bit more. And I think the average time was between 1 minute and 15 and 1 minute and 18 seconds. So it was fairly fast and, you know, it's very reliable, especially if you still don't have Tricarus. However, if you want to make this team safer, maybe you can add some more shield runes. And yeah, the thing here is that if the boss was to take your diva here, the light Chakram Dancer here, then she's on violent runes, so she may stun your full team, then proc some more, and of course she can get another turn and stun your full team again, so the boss may kill one of your units and then you're pretty much done. So especially if the unit that gets killed is your only boomerang. So yeah, for the turn order here, Shayna goes first because she can AoE defense rake, then your Raok, who can actually wipe a wave if he gets a few lucky strikes now and then. And then it will be ideal for Sarina to move, and after her moves Talia. And after that, moves your D.Va. Maybe D.Va can move before Talia as well, it will be okay. So in my case, my Talia moves before my Sabrina, which is not too good. However, for this particular comp, it doesn't matter a lot. However, if you are looking for a safe comp, then you can actually take out the Raok and include a Fran. So after I show you a couple of runs and a lot of results of rounds of 10 runs with this team, I will show you the team with Fran instead of Raok. That team will be slower, but in 200 runs, it didn't fail even once. So, you know, that's more reliable and more RNG proof, you know? However, you know, RNG in this game, if the opponent was to take a violent unit of yours, you know what violent does. Sometimes, one violent unit can kill your full team, or actually make your full team get killed. If you are out of immunity and D.Va gets to stun the full team, even if you have Fran, then there's nothing you can do about it. So one thing you can do about it is replacing D.Va for another Shayna. So going 2 Shaynas will be great here as well. If you don't have 2 Shaynas, you can use any other twin out there. Doesn't matter. So yeah, this team should work with any twins. But the ones that are mandatory are actually Shayna and, well, 1 Shayna. That's all you need. 1 Shayna. Then the others, doesn't matter who they are. So yeah, we're in one of the LD elemental dungeons. So if you have a defense raker, all you need is 2 defense rake, and then you have 4 twins, so they will deal tons of damage. Doesn't matter which element they are. So that's pretty much it, guys, for this one. So after this, I will show you the team with Fran, and I will tell you which are the minimum stats that you need for this dungeon. But first, I will let you watch the end of these runs. So that was my friend, and now I want to tell you a few things about NecroB12. Now, the fastest units that you will face here are the two golems that go alongside Grego during the mini-boss stage. They have 169 speed, so all of your units should be above 169 speed, and then you will not need the speed leader from D.Va. So that means that you can use the attack leader from Shayna and therefore deal more damage. And you won't have any problems here at this dungeon. So guys, you can trade D.Va for any other twin, then make your Shayna be the leader of the squad, and you will gain the attack leader for dungeons from Shayna, and therefore deal more damage and clear this faster and maybe safer. So yeah, I went for the speed lead anyways, because I wanted to make it as fair as possible, because you know, I had max towers, I had some nice runes, even though I didn't give very good runes to these units, some of them have some decent runes. So I wanted to be as fair as I can with all of you who are still trying to build a Tricaru and you are trying to get good runes. So I want to show you a team that can win even with mid-tier runes. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I will let you watch the end of these runs, and then I will show you the results of rounds of 10 rounds with this team that has Fran. And now the average time is about 15 seconds slower than the other version. However, this one didn't fail me even once. So guys, again, if you enjoyed this, please leave a thumbs up, leave a comment, subscribe. Remember, if you have any questions about the game, you let me know in the comment section and I will be very, very happy to reply. I will leave you with the rest of the rounds and then I will show you the results. So guys, see you all in the next one. Bye bye.